guys, be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video where we will rank every single figure in all of Elite Series 70 from worst to best in my own personal opinion. Also, go over to Ringside Collectibles and pick up any of the figures you see in today's video, guys. Use the promo code MDTOYS and you will save 10%. Tons and tons of great pre-orders, action figures, playsets, and many, many more over there on their website. Go over there, save some money, and do it now. What is good, everybody? Welcome to an epic My Damn Toys video. Today, we have another WWE Elite Series 72-in-1 Elite figure review on the brand new Elite 70 Mr. McMahon and Seth freaking Rollins. The brand new Raw Tag Team Champion Seth Rollins at that last night. Him and Braun Strowman actually won, or two nights ago, whatever day, Monday Night Raw, they won the Raw Tag Team Championships. And here he is in the flesh. He comes with the IC title. They look good. I'm very excited for, I don't know, I'm actually not that excited for these two. If you want me to be real with you, I'm really not. I mean, I really don't like this one because, you know, it's just a re-release of other sets. I mean, I do like the best mold we got going on, but, you know, it's a re-release head scan and all of that. We got a Flashback McMahon, which I didn't really care for, but let's just dive right in. Maybe they'll turn out better. And in this video, guys, we are ranking all of Elite Series 70. Should be a very interesting ranking. And let's just go ahead and dive in, guys. Let's spin them around. You got a beautiful picture of McMahon and Seth here. On the back, you do get other pictures. You get a picture of McMahon here, and then you get a picture of Seth freaking Rollins here. Got a little bio read up. If you'd like to read it, you can pause it right now. On the other side, we have their names, Mr. McMahon, Seth freaking Rollins. I call him Sethel. And that is it for their packaging, guys. I mean, that's pretty straightforward, you know. It is what it is. But let's go ahead and crack these guys out of their packaging. Alright, guys, well, here is Vincent Kennedy McMahon and Seth freaking Rollins out of their packaging, looking pretty sweet and swept. I don't know what the hell I just said, but getting into it here, at first glance, you know, I'm not the biggest fan of either of the figures, you know. I mean, they are what they are. I do like the body molds for them, but being this is a re-release head scan, as we mentioned, and then this, I'm not really getting a Vince McMahon head scan vibe from this. I guess it kind of looks like a younger McMahon, but at the same time, I'm not really, I don't know. We'll just get into it deeper and just kind of see how it feels, but what we're going to do is take a closer look at Vince McMahon's accessories and then Vince McMahon, and then we'll come back and take a closer look at Seth Rollins' accessories and then Seth Rollins, and then when that is all complete, we will be ranking all of Elite Series 70 from worst to best. Alright guys, so getting into Vince McMahon's accessories, he does come with a pair of interchangeable hands, as all the Elites do. You get the shaking hands, or the handshaking hand, whatever you want to call these, or the waving hands, or the sort of like, welcome to WrestleMania, you know, sort of like leading somebody, or like, you know, kind of giving yourself a gesture, like he is on the back of the packaging right here. You see Mike holding hand, and then this hand. That's what that is right there. So that is what you get. You also get the microphone that he's holding on the back, except instead of a black handle, it is a silver handle. I think we've gotten this with the Howard Finkel figure. We may have gotten it with Mean Gene. I can't remember exactly, but nonetheless, there is our microphone. And then it comes with this blue platform, and to be honest with you, I think this is how you build it right here. You take it, and you kind of take these holes with this big square, and you plug it in here. And then you plug it in at the other, is that how you, I honestly don't know if I'm doing this correctly. Okay, so what you do is you plug the two, you come with these four panels, and you take them and you plug them into these little holes in each side, and you make a square, and then you come back with your large square, and you plug it in like so to make your platform. So that's pretty cool. You could use this for your entrance stages or something. I'm not exactly sure what the hell I'll use it for, but now you got a little kiddie pool. So there you go. Now you have a little hot tub for your figures. That's a little fig hack for you right there. Maybe we can do a fig hack hot tub bull crap. I don't freaking know what the hell I'm saying, but there's our platform. So you come with this platform, and then you're supposed to stand on it with Vince McMahon, and he's supposed to announce and things of that ish. I guess you could put this in the middle of the ring. Again, you could do like a freaking hot tub match. I don't know. But that pretty much does it for Vince McMahon's accessories, guys. So with that being said, let's move on to Vince McMahon himself. So taking a closer look at Vince McMahon, guys, here is the head scan that I'm talking about. And I don't know. I don't know about you. I would love to know down below in the comment section what you think of this head scan. Do you think this is a good head scan? I'm just not, I feel like there's a little bit of likeness, but it just doesn't scream Vince McMahon. I think it's like the eyes or something are throwing me off. It's like it could be like Vince McMahon his cousin or his uncle or something, but I'm not getting a straightforward Vince McMahon. I just don't like this head sculpt, to be honest with you. Another one of those true effects head skins that just doesn't hit for me. It just misses the mark, but going down, I love the suit. I love suited figures. I think they're great. You do get an ab crunch under there, I'm pretty sure, underneath this vest. I think I did see an ab crunch in there, so that's nice. You get a black tie, white little little collar. You get the WWE logo there. And then you have a nice suited body going all around. You have the gray legs with these capri pants going on, or these slacks, whatever you want to say. Then you have like a charcoal gray slash brown color on the shoes. We've seen this body mold before with the Toys R Us mail away exclusive Vince McMahon, which we will compare to in this video with this figure. They're the exact same figure with a different head scan pretty much. And yeah, Vince is pretty much self-explanatory, man. Nothing too crazy, suited body. I mean, it is a nice figure. I just don't like the head sculpt. I may switch it around, may move some parts around and try to make a different suited character. I don't know what we'll do with it. But that about does it for this Vince McMahon Elite figure, guys. So with that being said, let's take a closer look at some Vince McMahon Elite figure comparisons. So for our Vince McMahon Elite figure comparisons, guys, you will see that we have the brand new Elite 70 in the middle. We have my little Paul Heyman Build-A-Figure with a Vince McMahon head sculpt on the left that I got on eBay a long time ago. And then we have the Mail Away Toys R Us exclusive that a fan, Derek Henry, sent me, which I really appreciate, bro. I love this figure so much. And the freaking comparison right here would not be possible without you, so thank you so much. But taking a look here, this is the same exact body mold again, but we have a gray suit here, and then you have the blue and gray suit here. And it's literally the same figure. You have a blast from the past. You have a flashback Vince, and then you have a current day, more older Vince here, and I like both of them a lot, even though I'm just not sold on this head scan. See, this actually looks like Vince McMahon, in my opinion. I think that it kind of has that expression, those eyes look like Vince, and so I like this one a lot more. However, I like the body. I think they do a good job of a body mold, even though I feel like this guy's super duper tall. I mean, he is supposed to be, I think, 6'5 or 6'6, so I guess it makes sense, but I don't know. I like the older Vince better, but this isn't a bad figure at all. I know this one's just a freaking, I mean, look at this guy. He's super duper short, but again, he's on a Paul Heyman body, and he was a placeholder until I got this one, and now this one. So now I guess I could head swap this to give me, like, I guess acetone that logo off. I'd have a different looking Vince if I wanted to. I don't know. We'll see about it, but that pretty much does it for our Vince McMahon Elite figure comparisons, guys. Now let's take a closer look at Seth Rollins' accessories. So to be honest, guys, Seth Rollins' accessories aren't that special. I mean, you get a beautiful white Intercontinental Championship. Obviously, this is from, this is one night after reclaiming the Intercontinental Championship at SummerSlam 2018 when he took on Dolph Ziggler, and then he reformed the Shield, I guess, is what this is supposed to be. Obviously, he was a part of the Shield, and then they went on and fought that dumb group of Dolph Ziggler, Braun Strowman, and Drew McIntyre in Australia, and then now Braun Strowman and Seth Rollins are tag team champions. So that just shows you sort of what happened. In a year's time, you go from fighting somebody for no reason to being a tag champ with them. So that's what you get. And then you get the black fist for the gloves. You get the mic holding hands that come on the figure. And then you get the black fist for fisted glove hands. And that's it for Seth Rollins' accessories, guys. Pretty straightforward, pretty self-explanatory. And now that we've done that, let's take a closer look at the man, Seth Rollins. So taking a closer look at Seth Rollins, guys, getting into the head sculpt again, we've seen this before on many figures. I think it was Elite 64, the Top Talents 2018, and now with the Elite 70 Seth Rollins, and we've gotten it on a couple basics. So we have seen this head scan quite a lot, you know, to this point. We have seen, you know, this head scan, and it's a great head scan, don't get me wrong. It's the best Rollins head scan to date, but I am sick of it. I think I'm over it by this point. You know, I think we're ready for a new one. I kind of like that new one we're getting with that new basic that we saw at Comic-Con, you know, with the more serious face. I'm ready to see that one in action. And see what that looks like when they're finished with it. But going down, this is a new vested mold. We've never seen this vest mold from Mattel before, and I think this vest mold would look great on a Seth Rollins figure if you acetoned off this logo, which I will be doing. I will be acetoning that off because he doesn't even have it on the back of the packaging. They don't ever have that logo there, so I guess I'm going to take this off and then maybe use this for a Seth Rollins custom, or maybe put it on my Top Talents, or I don't know. We'll move it around. We'll see what we can do with it, but nonetheless, I am getting rid of the logo, and we're going to do some stuff. It reminds me a lot of the Elite 20 Rollins, you guys remember, which was just like a different Rollins. It had the black sleeves and it had the ponytail head scan. It's pretty much that same figure, but with a different head sculpt and a different vest sculpt. Going down, you have your regular Shield crotch, Shield legs, Shield boots, Shield gloves. I mean, it's basically a Shield Seth Rollins with the Top Talents head scan on it and a new newly molded vest. However, I will say, I feel like this figure has better feet. I don't really know. I mean, I could be wrong about that, but it feels like it stands a lot better than the others, but it looks the same, so I'm not sure what to say about that. But now that we have covered Seth Rollins, guys, let's take a closer look at some Seth Rollins Elite figure comparisons. So getting into some Shield Elite Seth Rollins figure comparisons, guys, let's go ahead and look here. You have the Elite 70 in the middle. You have the Elite 25 on the left with a head swap, which is supposed to be this current look. I used this for videos before this figure came out. I was using this as my current, you know, 2018 Rollins when that was happening, obviously, on television. And then you have his first Elite, I do believe. This is like the Elite 26, or no, the Elite 21. I can't remember the Elite series, to be honest with you guys. But maybe the Elite 25 was his first Elite, and this is Elite 31. Maybe that's what I'm thinking of. I can't remember. But nonetheless, let's go ahead. Maybe Elite 33. Who gives a damn? Let's get into it here. Again, they're pretty much the same exact figure, guys, except for different head scans. And then, of course, a new vest mold. This is the exact same figure. I think these skin tones actually are different. They went with a lighter skin tone for this, and then the darker skin tone here, which I think is pretty weird. So maybe if you pop this head sculpt on a regular Seth Rollins Elite, I think the skin tone would actually be off. It looks like they went with the Daniel Bryan skin tone for this guy. So that's just something to take note of. But besides that, that pretty much does it for your Seth Rollins Shield Elite figure comparisons. And now that we've done that, guys, it is time to finally rank all of Elite Series 70 from worst to best. All right, guys, so it is finally time to rank all of Elite Series 70 from worst to best in my own personal opinion. And to be honest with you, it was a pretty tough ranking considering that a lot of these figures, you know, I went in wanting to love and I like a lot of them. I really do. But at the end of the day, some of them did disappoint me upon execution. And we will get into that once I tell you my ranking. But you know how these rankings work. We're going to start off with the worst figure in the set, in my opinion. Coming in at number 6, guys, we do have Vince McMahon. Yes, Vince McMahon is coming in at number 6. It was really close between 5 and 6 for me personally because I felt like these figures at 5 and 6 really weren't that different than what we've gotten in the past here. And so Vince McMahon is going to come in at number 6. I really just can't see Vince in this head sculpt. And this is basically a re-release of the Toys R Us figure. Even though that figure is pretty rare, I still am just not a big fan of this figure. Again, I think if it had more likeness to Vince and it had more of a tie to this figure, I would probably feel differently about it, but I really don't. So therefore, it must come in at number 6, and he starts off as the worst figure in the set, in my personal opinion. Coming in at number 5, guys, I bet you guys could see this coming. It is Seth Rollins, and for Seth Rollins, I think that, you know, it's basically, just like Vince, it's a re-release of a Shield Elite Seth Rollins. I cannot stand the Shield figures. That's another reason, and we didn't even get a new head scan for this guy. They also used the lighter skin tone, and it's just, you know, I really do like the vest mold, which is why I think it bumped it up over the Vince McMahon. I really do like this vest mold, but at the end of the day, I couldn't rank it any higher than 5, and that is because it's pretty much a re-release, though I do love Seth Rollins. I just could not rank it any higher. Coming in at number 4, guys, I bet you guys are going to be pretty shocked about this one, but it's going to be the NXT Jack the Ripper Finn Balor, and I know I can already hear the moans and groans and everything, but I have to tell you, this is probably one of my biggest disappointments that I've ever had in an action figure, especially from Mattel, okay? So with this head sculpt, me and Brad talked about it a lot. I just don't see any resemblance to Finn Balor in this head sculpt. I'm really disappointed in it. I also got like some bad black chipping here on one of mine. The other one is the one I reviewed, but on this one you can see there's a lot more black on there than there's supposed to be. The red color isn't exactly accurate to me. Again, they put too much black on the face scan. I don't like this growling face that they use. While I love the idea of it, the execution didn't work out for me. The haircut's a little bit off. The shape of the head's a little bit off. Not to mention they added a beard to this figure when he didn't even have a beard at the time, I think. And so I love the accessories, and I think it's a badass figure as far as, you know, like they gave us the ripped up torso, which is terrific. I think that that's awesome, but they should be giving us that, right? And I just think that the head wasn't executed to the best, and me and Brad talked about it a while, and we agreed that this would be number 4. I just could not rank it any higher, and it really does disappoint me. It really hurts my feelings, but I do love the figure nonetheless, like as far as, you know, everything else is concerned. And I think the figure looks great with the hat on. I think that you could get away with it, but maybe for now, you know, straight out of the packaging, I can't change my ranking. It has to be number 4 because I'm going to have to do some major overhaul on this figure to get it to the way I like. And I know that was a mouthful, but that is my number 4 ranking, and I had to explain myself. Coming in at number 3, guys, is Johnny Gargano, and I know this one is probably going to be like, whoa, what the hell? And the reason that Johnny Gargano is number 3 is because, first of all, mine has some paint chips in the hair, but he's also has this lower leg problem, which we discussed. I cannot stand that they did that lower leg thing. Another doc is they left off the emoji on the shorts. So standing alone, it is at number 3 with that lower leg problem, which is just such a bonehead thing. I mean, my God, why did that have to happen? But with that and the emoji, I did want to rank it at number 3. I know a lot of people don't really care. They love Johnny Gargano so much that it doesn't matter to them, but I'm not in that company. I do like Johnny Gargano a lot, but for Johnny Football, for me, he's coming in at number 3 in the rankings. At number 2, guys, it is going to be EC3, and to be honest with you, I mean, this figure right here is damn perfect. perfect. If you want me to be honest with you, it is damn perfect. It's freaking nice. It looks great. Great head sculpt. Great accessories. Great interchangeable hands. Great attire. Perfect figure from head to toe, to be honest with you. But it's not going to overcome my number one spot, which is going to ultimately be my boy Dolph Ziggler. And I did complete a trade today with one of my boys on Instagram, and we did make a trade for the alternate version, which is the Chase variant, which is going to be a lot better than this, which is the the regular black version. And the only thing that docks points on this Dolph Ziggler is the black outsoles and the large arms. But it didn't matter. I really do love this Dolph Ziggler head scan. I love that we get a cloth jacket. I love that just we're getting an updated Dolph Ziggler figure, and I'm super excited for it. So I rank Dolph Ziggler number one, but EC3 is a close number two. I think that ultimately, you know, if I wasn't biased towards Dolph Ziggler, EC3 would probably be the number one figure in Elite Series 70, but I'm going to rank Dolph Ziggler number one, and you guys are just going to have to get over it, I guess. I put Ziggler number one, EC3 number two, Johnny Gargano number three, Finn Balor number four, Seth Rollins number five, and Vince McMahon number six, and that does it for my ranking of Elite Series 70 from worst to best. But that is going to do it for today's 2-in-1 figure review, guys, on Elite Series 70, Mr. McMahon and Seth Rollins. Again, they came in at the bottom of the tier for me as far as Elite Series 70 is concerned, but it was a really good wave, you know, really strong wave. One thing I will say again is this Finn Balor, man, the face scan just really upsets me. Maybe it'll change in the ranks. Maybe it can excel, you know, up to, you know, higher on the list once I, you know, fix it up, paint it up a little bit. But, you know, time will tell, and I have to rank it based off how it is straight out of the packaging. I can't, you know, deduct point. I can't add points to it because you can switch and swap a figure around. You know, I have to go based off because not everybody that buys these figures is going to, you know, have the parts and the paint and everything to switch around and fix the figures up to the way that they should be made. So the way I rank them is straight out of the packaging, Mattel factory made. But overall, I mean, if you guys want an updated Seth Rollins in S.H.I.E.L.D. gear, or you want a flashback Mr. McMahon, if you're a flashback collector, you really like him, or you know, you just want to complete, you know, your sets, you definitely got to grab these figures. But as far as I'm concerned, they are definitely skippable, and I don't think I've ever said that about any figures in the way, but there's so many S.H.I.E.L.D. Seth Rollins, and this isn't my favorite Vince McMahon figure, so I mean, in my honest opinion, I think you could skip these, but if you want to pick them up, you can go over to Ringside Collectibles. You can pick up any of these figures you see right here using promo code MDTOYS at their website. You can save 10%. You can get some other figures. That Thunderstorm, I don't know if you guys just heard that, but it made me jump out of my effing skin, and it made me almost crap myself. But nonetheless, that is going to do it for this 2-in-1 figure review, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed my ranking. I hope you guys enjoyed the reviews. Tomorrow will be Action Figure Surgery, and I'm super hyped for it because it's going to be epic as hell. And I'm just super duper excited, man. It's going to be a really good video. We're going to get some surgery in here. Everybody in this video, I think, will be included in that video. Maybe. I'm not sure. We'll have to see about that. But that is going to do it. I'm going to go ahead and take cover from this storm. Hopefully, I don't get killed by it. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.